So, where are we going?
Your choice. You want me to prove it travels in time? Why not suggest a date?
Any date.
Any date you so please.
But if I go back into the past and change something, won't it have a drastic effect on the future?
The future is always writing itself. Time itself can be written, allowing for hundreds of thousands of possible futures awaiting in your future. Infinite possibilities are waiting. That's the exciting thing. The future you will have may not be the future you are going to have. Make sense?
Not really.
And take off that high visibility jacket off, you look ridiculous.
Coming from the bow tie wearing time traveller.
What are you saying?
I'm saying you're not one to criticise.
You still haven't answered my question. Any date and I shall make it happen.
Well, I've always been fascinated in travelling back to the past, seeing yesteryear and how they coped with various obstacles.
Interesting. Okay, shall we say England 1900s?
Maybe 1901. Just to mix things up.
Very well. England 1901. Let's see what you got. Out those doors lies London, 1901.
Are you sure this is 1901?
Yep, pretty sure. Why'd you ask?
I'm not a historian, and believe me, I'm not. But I'm pretty sure they didn't have a Ford Focus in 1901.
Ah. Here's a problem. There was a time wind in the vortex throwing us off. We're not in 1901. We're in 2001. Easy mistake. Well, we might as well just leave. This place looks like the back end and beyond.
Doctor, you might want to get back out here.
What's going on?
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
What?
Listen, we mean you no harm.
Stay back, demon!
We're not demons. We've only just turned up.
It's true. I don't know who you think we are, but I assure you, we are not them.
What's that box, then? Made the noise of the devil himself. A wheezy, whirring sort of noise.
Ah, yes. Well, I'm not going to lie, as you seem to be very wide people. That's a mode of transportation, the equivalent of my car, so to speak. Whenever I park, it makes that noise. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to scare you.
Rubbish!
I'm not exactly sure we can trust them, John. John, listen to me. Me and my friend are as real as any of you are. We have just arrived, and in fact, I have no idea what's going on, or where we are.
You want to know what's going on?
Well, yes.
Behind you.
You've got to be joking. There's demons inside that place. Ghosts of the past. A lone house that once stood on Wilson Avenue. And let me guess, anyone who goes in never emerges.
You think this is funny?
Please do excuse my friend, he's rather judgmental.
So, you're telling me that house is haunted?
Right.
Wrong. There's no such thing as ghosts.
Go in there then.
I beg your pardon?
Well, you don't believe us. The colony has no occupants and the door's always unlocked.
Please, I have far better things to-
We'll do it.
What?
Yeah.
I would say we would check back on you, but we won't. Two more souls the house will claim.
Oh, shut up. Fine, fine. We'll go on your poxy house of horrors. Off with you. Go back to your Twitter and backgammon. Come on, while my backs are turned, let's get into TARDIS and go. Because I don't have time to investigate something that isn't there.
Are you scared?
Toby, I've faced hundreds of monsters, the likes you won't even believe. You think I'm scared of a house?
Prove it. Come in.
Fine, fine. But it's just a waste of time.
Hello? Anyone here?
Why did you volunteer us like that?
Because it doesn't take a genius to see that these people are frightened. If we can perhaps bring some crumb of comfort, then so be it.
I'm telling you now, you'll only be disappointed.
If there's anyone in here, we don't mean to wish you any harm. Not me or my friend. Ooh, suddenly got a lot colder.
Sudden decreases in temperature are common in old houses like these. Not any indication of ghosts at all.
Please excuse my friend. We're just trying to find out if you're here.
Or if you're even real. Toby, please. We are wasting valuable...
Doctor, you okay?
I'm fine. Maybe I just leaned back too much.
It looked like you were pushed.
No. No. Don't jump to conclusions. Sounds like it was a wind coming from upstairs.
Should we go upstairs?
You can. You're the one that wanted this.
Very well. Hello?
Let's get one thing straight. I don't believe in ghosts. It's scientifically impossible. To regain consciousness after you die cannot be achieved. I can't tell you what happened when you died. I've not experienced death yet. But one thing I'm certain of is that you can't come back. You can't come back as a spirit or a ghost or a poltergeist, whatever you want to call yourself. There's no such thing. There is nothing here except memories and us. Why am I even justifying myself?
Toby? Toby! Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. You?
Yeah, I think I'm fine. Hello? Can you hear me? No. Can't be.
Now, once you've been placed backwards in time, you must go about avoiding yourself and all contact. Any contact whatsoever could cause a paradox.
Who are you? Get away from me!
No, you don't understand. I'm trying to help.
Get away!
Did you hear that?
Yes. Yes, I did. They say this place is haunted. Don't believe it myself. Everything can be explained with science.
Toby! It had to be you, didn't it?
Doctor?
Toby! Toby, can you hear me? Toby, don't worry, I'm here. I'll fix this. Where are you? No wonder it detected that area. Because they are. Echoes of a past and future colliding in the present. Is that even possible? Don't you worry. I will rescue you. But first, I have to settle something.
Hello?
Another one! Oh, good lord!
Don't worry, love. The dragon will take care of it.
Sorry, I'm looking for a friend. He's tall, thin, wears a bow tie and an awful tweed jacket. He was just here a moment ago.
I know this house had some history, but I'm not sure how much of this I can take. I'm scared, Harold.
I think it's best you be on your way.
Sorry, where am I?
Out.
When am I?
Out now. You're trespassing in our home. You're like the rest of them.
Okay. Let's not raise any voices. Calm down. My name's Toby, and I pose no threat to you.
Whilst you are under my roof, you follow my rules. Now, do I have to force you outside, or will you leave on your own will?
Okay, I'll leave. Good day, sir, madam.
Tell me everything there is to know about that house.
I see a friend isn't with you. Would you like to come on in?
No, he's good. You've been getting reports of people disappearing once they enter the house, yes? There's got to be some records of where they turned up.
Turned up? What?
People are being displaced in time, Father. There's an alien of great power sitting in that house. It sends people back in time. Now, the angel looked old and damaged, which suggests Toby can't have been sent back that far. Tell me, is there any abnormal appearances or deaths in history books regarding that house?
Just leave history alone. You could bring back a great demon that once stood here.
Listen, Father. I intend on helping, but first I need to know a date. A date in which all these deaths occurred.
According to the history records of this street, most appearances tend to be in 1901. Don't you go unearthing demons in this here community.
1901, follow back the latest time disturbance and bingo! 1901, Toby, I'm coming.
Let me in, dammit!
Why should we trust you?
Let me in, I have a friend who can help to solve all of this.
And here he comes now.
Oh, good, you're right.
Doctor, a bit of help wouldn't go amiss.
A reaper? Now that is interesting. Toby, stay where you are.
Do I have a choice?
What are you doing? No, just step back in the TARDIS.
Just gotta ask something first.
It's locked, I've already tried.
Who the devil are you? Your salvation. Quick question, how long has this creature been here? Here's how it's gonna work. Question, answer, shoot.
Whenever people like you turn up.
In the last year, how many times has this happened?
About a dozen or so times.
Okay, final question. When you push people out of their demise, does the creature disappear?
For heaven's sake! Yes!
Okay, thank you for your cooperation. Enjoy the rest of your day.
Ooh, this is a bit close.
Right, Tubby, run!
Who the devil was that man?
Exactly that, my dear. The devil.
Right, okay, what the hell was that thing?
It's called a reaper. Strange how they're here. I like to refer to them as time doctors. They live in the time vortex and they search out any time disturbances, such as temporal paradoxes. They leave the time vortex and sterilize the area by devouring everything.
So I'm a paradox?
In theory, yes. But really, they're trying to help. There's these race of beings called the Weeping Angels. Terrifying creatures. Creatures made of pure stone that have the power to send you back in time, consuming all the days that you should have had but no longer have. They basically feed on the energy left in your wake. But here's the thing. They can't move whilst you're in a direct line of sight. If you turn around or blink, then that's it.
Right, okay, so what's the plan now?
The year 3001. Scientists doing time travel experiments. Bound to get lost. I've been meaning to pay them a visit for quite some time. Well, I guess I got sidetracked. Well, this is the only reason I can explain it. Might as well check out. Follow my lead. Improvise.
Scientists doing time travel experiments in the year 3000, but something's gone wrong. You sent your guinea pig back further in time than you expected, correct?
I'm sorry. Who the hell are you?
We just appeared out of thin air, you're smart, figure it out. You've been doing experiments, sending an apple one day into the future and past, but you see, sending a human a day into the past is different. Human beings are not apples.
We haven't even done it yet! How do you know this?
Because the past is suffering from this. We are time travelers, and this is the year 3000. You aren't supposed to do time travel experiments yet, hence this failing. We might have caught you just in time. Do not do the time travel experiment.
We can't. It's all been funded for and cannot be altered.
You don't understand. What you have done here has caused this giant plug hole in the past. That's right, isn't it?
That's right.
It's not our problem. We put enough into this. We need this. And quite frankly, I don't believe you are time travelers.
Right. Okay. Okay. You see that? That's the rip that you caused in the skin of time. This is just a screwdriver. I can't even change a bulb. And yet I can rip through it with just a screwdriver. You might not have done it now, but this is the damage you're going to cause.
It can't be.
Walk through. Go on. If you're doubting us, then walk through.
He's got a point. Prove us wrong. Tell you what, I'll go first. The year 2001.
This has to be some kind of joke, Shirley.
This isn't a joke, and don't call me Shirley. Want more proof? This is a rip even further into the past that you've caused.
What the bleeding hell is this?
Ah, hello again, 1901. Me, 3001. We're going to settle this right now. 1901, I know you're sick of people appearing, but please bear with me.
So we caused this?
Right. Yes, let me explain. You sciencey guys are doing experiments to send a person backwards in time. Not only are you not supposed to have this technology yet because stuff like this happens, but you would have almost certainly lost contact with this wannabe time traveler. Now I'm talking to you at a point of time where you haven't done it yet, but you will, and in doing so you have caused a rip spanning back through hundreds and hundreds of years, which brings me on to my next point. There are these time-sensitive beings called the Weaving Angels. They feed on potential time energy, normally by displacing someone backwards in time, feasting on timelines. But all it takes is one rogue Weeping Angel to pass by and spot this, and BAM! They think it's a free course meal. But what they don't know is that it's the side effects that can cause. But because people are stupid and believe in the superstition of ghosts, they investigate the house, only to find they have been sent back in time by the Weeping Angel. Which leads me on to you, 1901. These people appear in your house, and then the flying demon appears, correct? Well, that is a being called the Reaper. They would search out disturbances in time, such as... anyone? Temporal paradoxes? Rips in the fabric of time? You guessed it! And the people from the 21st century are being sent back in time is certainly a disturbance. But not only that, the Reaper notices a rip has happened in the time vortex. They all surround that area, which is why every time someone appears in your house, that thing appears. They're essentially cleaning the wound, believe it or not.
So, what, we just let that Reaper do its thing?
No, because it will just keep on going and going with no outcome. Toby, step back to the present, please.
You expect me to believe such dribble?
Shut up, I'm trying to think. Scientists from the year 3000.
We do have names!
Names aren't important. You have seen the carnage and destruction you have caused. Stop the experiment, call it a day.
Not to interrupt your big speech, but...
Ah, yes, the elephant in the room. Toby, keep your eyes fixed on that statue. As long as you're looking at it, it won't budge.
We can't just call it off like that. A lot of time and research has gone into this experiment. A lot of funding and...
With all due respect, you're morons, all of you, trying to perfect something that you shouldn't even have in the first place. Time has been ruptured in three different places, same location, just different times. You keep this up and this tear will just get bigger and bigger, then who knows what will happen. But it's down to you, for goodness sake. Take some responsibility for your actions.
Dr. Tagout, you take stone duty.
On it.
Hello, sorry, what are your names?
Well, I'm Edward. And my co-partner is Charles.
Hello, nice to meet you. My name's Toby. Sorry, my friend's a bit brash. But he does have a point. But it's okay, because there's still time to make things right. We're all human at the end of the day, right?
Well...
not a word from you.
Please don't make us throw our lives researching the bin!
You don't have to throw it away, though. All we're asking you is to stop the experiment. Keep your research, notes, and all the other bits of scientific equipment. Just expand the idea. Maybe just stick with using an apple for now.
Toby, I can't hold on much longer.
Tag out?
Nope, better idea. Edward, Charles, you want redemption? Keep your eyes on this here angel. Do not take your eyes off it. Same goes for you, Mr. and Mrs. Batterby. Do not fight it, just keep looking at it. And for goodness sake, do not stare into its eyes.
What would that do?
Opens you up to him.
Have you got a plan?
Yes.
Is that a lie?
Somewhat. Even if we did take down the rip, the angel would still be here, and would probably kill us on the spot. Right, Toby, with me. Remember, don't take your eyes off it. Toby, listen carefully. Hold on to the console. Don't let go. Hold on for your life.
Okay, sure.
Oh, and if you wouldn't mind keeping your eyes on the angel.
What? What have you done?
Just give me a moment.
What happens if I look away? Would it send me back in time again?
Probably not. It knows you're the person that just got sent back. It'll probably kill you. I've seen this type of stuff before.
I can't hold it much longer.
You don't need to any longer. Grab the console firmly.
How can a box do that?
Never mind that, love. Why has he left it here? Why in God's name did you leave that statue thing here?
Just keep your eyes on it, remain calm.
You have just summoned a demon to appear. And you're telling me to remain calm?
I wouldn't have put it there if I thought it would cause any danger to you. You do this and you won't have any more disturbances. Trust me.
What's happening?
The timelines! They're collapsing!
Wait, what does that even mean?
Time will literally disintegrate, merging the past, present and future all at once in one solid time stream!
Wait, like... back at the oil rig?
No, far worse. Listen, what are your names? Ed? Charles? Please see what's happening. This is real, all of it. Don't do the experiment.
All right, we won't.
They promise not to do it.
We promise.
What's happening?
They promise not to do it, and time is going back the way it should be.
It's true then. You are time travellers.
What's happening is that all three tears in the time continuum are being closed. The past, present and future.
We could obviously pay you, but I'm sorry. We just can't risk it.
You're joking, right? No! No!
What's the matter?
Did you see that man with silver helmet?
Yes, yes. What about him?
That man is responsible for the deaths of many innocent people. He is one of the most dangerous bounty hunters alive. And I never found out who he was.
But what are we waiting for? Let's jump in the TARDIS and...
The time vortex has just taken a massive strain. I will be very surprised if I can ever travel back to the year 1901, or let alone 3001 ever again without time disintegrating.
So that's it then? Everything back to normal.
Only one way to find out. Father, hello. Earlier you mentioned a history record of the entire street. Do you mind if I have a quick glance? Well, you see, the Reaper can cut through pure stone. I knew if 1901... Sorry. The Battersby's kept watching it wouldn't stand a chance. Still, all's well that ends well. The reading must be off. Toby, come on.
Wait, you can't just leave like that. I have so many questions.
And then you're going to get the answer to.
But what do I tell the community?
Tell them that you saved them.
They won't believe that. I'm just one man.
And who do you think stopped this haunting? This man right here. Be it a little help from me, but it looks like he doesn't want to take the credit. You're a good man, Father. I can see that you think more for the community than you do yourself. Just tell them that you're safe. Goodbye, Father.
Wait! What if that thing comes back here, or if there is another haunting?
Father, believe me. There's no such things as ghosts. You'll be fine. As for you, Toby... I think a proper trip to the past or the future is in order.